Today we cancel Sha'Carri Richardson. You may vaguely remember the name as someone who was complaining a while ago about being persecuted for some reason or another, and supposedly was all racist or somehow or something. All these controversies bleed together in the mind, and it's hard to keep them straight. So to clarify, Richardson is the female track star who was disqualified from the Olympics a couple of years ago because she tested positive for marijuana. And many people, including Richardson herself, complain that the rule against marijuana use is absurd and pointless, as marijuana is not likely to give you an advantage in competitive sports. And this is probably true, I guess, but me being the victim blamer that I am, I always more so wondered why she would use marijuana when she's in the middle of qualifying for the Olympics, given the fact that it's a banned substance. It may not be necessary to ban it at the Olympics, but it's even less necessary for Olympians to use it. And if I was hoping to compete in the Olympics and the Olympics had a rule outlawing the consumption of anything, like if they had a rule outlawing the consumption of Cheez-Its before competing and they had a test to determine who had used Cheez-Its, I'd be severely disappointed. I'd be confused. I wouldn't agree with the rule, but I still just wouldn't eat the Cheez-Its, as difficult as it would be to abstain, because it would be more important to me that I get to follow my dream and compete. But that's just me. So she chose to sacrifice the Olympics so that she could smoke weed. That makes her the moron, and that's really the story there. It should have been. But Richardson became famous for not racing at the Olympics, a famous victim of Olympic rules that apply to everyone, but somehow were personally oppressive to her specifically. And given that Richardson's primary claim to fame is her victimhood, it perhaps is no surprise that she is, or at least became, a totally insufferable brat. Which leads us to the latest update in the Richardson victimhood saga, where now she finds herself kicked off of an American Airlines flight after refusing to stop using her phone before takeoff. She recorded two videos documenting this confrontation with the flight attendants and other people on her flight, apparently convinced that she comes off as the good guy in the exchange. But you can judge for yourself. Here's the video.
Place it all the way under the seat in front of you.
Lying.
Larger carry-on luggage raising over.
Flying, not working today.
If you have small
vacation time, devices,
such as cell phones, tablets, and smartwatches, okay. Please yeah. Switch them.
I'm recording me, but you jumped now. In my video, so I caught you because you jumped in my video.
Into your seat.
You're harassing me at this point, so I think you should stop. I think you should stop. I think you should stop. You see him, right? Y'all see him, right? Y'all see him, right? Okay. Okay, but I'm sorry. It's not me. Talk to him. No, don't talk to me like that. I'm an adult. Do not talk to me like that. Do not talk to me like that. Tell him to stop. If you do not know what's going on, do not yell at me.
You can stop recording.
No, I'm not going to start recording because I was making a video to myself. I'm going to not start recording. And this video will show what you're doing. So I appreciate it. Who the f*** are you talking to, ma'am?
We don't need other people to get involved.
Thank you. Like, no.
Again with the taking the video in public thing. Why are you taking a video to begin with on your flight? No one cares that you're on a flight. You're taking a flight. That's not interesting. Why do you think that needs to be documented? Not everything needs to be documented. Okay, we don't need documentation, especially not all the documentation anyone does anymore is of their face. It's a selfie or a selfie video. Here's my face on a plane. Here's my face doing this. Here's my face walking down the street. Nobody cares. It's not interesting. And I know that I sound like a hypocrite because I am in front of a camera every single day, but that's also my job. And I can tell you, even in my job, like it, trust me, you see too much of me as it is. It could be a lot worse. I mean, all the time I've got the social media team here telling me, oh, you should do this video doing this or that. We need a selfie video of you doing this. I'm not doing that. No one needs to see that. It's not interesting. Give me a reason why I should be on camera. Some reason, and I'll do it. But you don't need to have your face on camera every second of the day. Okay? Now, in the second video, which I won't force you to watch, she argues with another passenger who rightly blames her for holding up the plane and making him miss his connection. She chides him for not being chivalrous and you know, not standing up to defend her against the intimidating flight attendants. And he responds to her by saying, and I quote, "I don't give a shit," which is both an eloquent argument and the morally correct one in this situation. Eventually, Richardson is escorted off the plane while the other passengers applaud. But the fact that nearly everyone on the plane was against her and that she had inconvenienced over 100 people for no reason at all was not enough to convince her that she was herself the villain of this story. Instead, she posted both videos to Instagram while threatening legal action against the airline for committing the crime of, I guess, expecting her to follow the rules that everyone else has to follow. This is a theme for Richardson, right? She really has trouble with requirements that apply to everyone. You don't have to like the requirements, okay? But they apply to everyone and no one else has a problem. Everyone else manages to follow them, but you. Why is it a problem for you? Everyone else managed to not smoke weed before they had to go race in the Olympics. You had an issue with it. Everyone else manages to like not be taking a selfie video right before takeoff. For some reason, you can't handle that. Indeed, she is personally injured by these requirements. The requirements are an attack against her. Not against everyone else who's just as subject to them, but against her because she is her. She is Sha'Carri Richardson, and she is the protagonist in the story of the human species. Now, fortunately, I don't have to go to great lengths, actually, in this cancellation to explain why Richardson is in the wrong, because it would seem that most people are on the same page on this one. Somewhat shockingly, this is the part that surprised me. Richardson has not garnered much public support, even after playing both the race and gender card after the fact. An Instagram post that diligently avoids anything resembling punctuation or proper sentence structure, Richardson wrote in part, "Tell me if I'll be wrong to pursue legal actions against the airline, American Airline. Not only did the man threaten me, but also an innocent bystander who simply just wanted a picture with me. In the beginning of the video, you can hear a Caucasian male state that he doesn't give a F as a man that male flight attendant is intimidating a woman. Also, the captain not doing anything to help the situation, and this flight attendant has the applause when I exited the plane when I'm pretty serious. The disrespect I receive would not have happened if I was a one of them." I don't know. One of them as in a white male, I guess, is what she meant to say. Because, of course, everyone on the plane would have been perfectly happy to miss their connecting flights if only the disturbance had been caused by a white male. I mean, I'll never forget the time, it's actually happened a couple times, when I threw a random temper tantrum in first class, delayed the plane by 45 minutes, caused 32 passengers to miss their connections. And everyone in the plane, they were so proud of me, they shook my hands one by one to thank me for it, while the flight attendant showered me with free flight vouchers and extra bags of complimentary peanuts. That is a thing that definitely happened in real life and not just in the fevered, marijuana-soaked mind of Sha'Carri Richardson. Anyway, in this case, her victim routine seems to not be resonating as much as she had hoped with the public. It could be that the public has become suddenly intelligent and discerning, which seems to be, Frank, extremely unlikely, or it could just be that people are simply sick and tired of loud-mouthed crybabies with main character syndrome who always seem to find problems and drama in the sorts of situations where everyone else manages to get along just fine. It's perhaps interesting to note that even as the public becomes increasingly and unreasonably tolerant of self-victimizing drama queens who look for every, you know, opportunity to be oppressed, they still don't want to deal with it on an airplane. People these days will put up with your shenanigans in almost any situation that is until your shenanigans might cause them to miss a connection in Chicago. That seems to be where the line is drawn. And it's good that the line is drawn somewhere. And that is why I must say, indeed, I think we all say, that Sha'Carri Richardson is today canceled. And that'll do it for this portion of the show as we move over to the members block. Hope to see you there. If not, talk to you tomorrow. Godspeed.